我们注意到一段时间以来，不断有人从大陆辗转地传出来了一些视频画面，显示很多人在打了疫苗之后就突然倒在了地上。这个场景恰好被一位外媒的记者看到了，外媒记者马上录下了这个情形，他们还阻止外媒的记者说不需要录像。外媒记者问他为什么不许录，为什么不许报道呢？他们无话可说。而且从泰国、缅甸等一些东南亚国家看，包括南美和非洲的一些国家，他们在打了中国的疫苗之后，确诊的人数非但没有减少，反而增多了。更可怕的是，很多人打了之后还出现了一些不良的反应。这是昨天广东虎门发生爆炸，现场硝烟弥漫，四川的一家中共的军工厂发生了爆炸，监控仪的视频拍到了这一过程。从视频的画面看，爆炸发生的非常突然和意外，很多人还正在工作。当爆炸起火的时候，很多人在仓皇地往出逃跑。看来啊，这不能不说是老天在惩罚中共啊。你在穷兵黩武，在制造的武器弹药，老天就把你这个武器弹药给你销毁掉。目前阿富汗的局势仍然处于混乱状况，一些民间的组织还在抵抗着塔利班，还有包括一些政府的军队也在抵抗着塔利班的进攻。阿富汗的副总统宣布出任临时总统。当看到塔利班组织占领了一些省会城市之后，阿富汗总统甘尼仓皇出逃。目前还在国内的阿富汗副总统沙雷17日宣布，他将暂时代理总统，领导人们继续抵抗阿富汗的塔利班组织。网上还传来消息说，阿富汗前民族英雄艾哈迈德·沙阿马苏德的儿子艾哈迈德·马苏德领导的北方军正在扩大根据地，目前已经打到了距喀布尔北部25英里远的地方。网友说，但愿这是真的，至少不会让塔利班一手遮天。从传出的消息看，这些民间的武装，包括塔利班副总统的政府军，他们的士气还是很高涨，他们并不畏惧塔利班。看来他们的存在将使塔利班很难在喀布尔等省会城市立足。最新消息，阿富汗副总统领导的部队已经对塔利班展开了全面的反击，现在他们已经夺回了一个城市，目前还在潘杰希尔峡谷附近与塔利班激战。目前阿富汗副总统领导的政府军和民间组织马苏德的武装已经联合起来了，他们在一起在抵抗着塔利班。加拿大总理特鲁多发表声明说，他们不承认塔利班组织的政权，不但不承认塔利班的政权，还要认定塔利班组织为恐怖组织集团。
No plans to recognize the Taliban as the government of Afghanistan. When they were in government 20 years agoCanada did not recognize them as a government. They have taken over and replaced a duly elected democratic government by force. And as you point out, they are a recognized terrorist organization under Canadian law.
刚刚英国首相约翰逊向全球发出警告说，都别承认塔利班政权。美国前国务卿蓬佩奥在接受福克斯采访时说，这届政府没有捍卫美国的强大，塔利班看到美国这么虚弱，所以他们才敢开着车撵了过来。
He's right about the number of troops that we had withdrawn. His logic is absolutely pathetic. We had drawn down from about 15,000 to about 2,500, and we had kept the lid on this thing. We had kept the strategic stability that mattered to the United States. President Trump wanted to get outRight. He wanted to get out when he started campaigning. He knew it was the right thing to do. We were executing that mission. But we had done so in a way that had made clear to the Taliban that there would be enormous costs connected to what they did if they touched an American, if they killed an American, or if they even so much as scared an American. And for goodness, for 11 plus months from February of 2020, there wasn't a single American killed after we'd cut the deal with the Taliban. Because the Taliban knew that that deal meant one thing. It meant that they had a set of obligations. If they failed to live up to them, there would be enormous costs imposed on that. And we did. They broke some of it while we were still in office, their power-sharing commitments, their commitments with respect to how they would respond to certain actions. And when they did, we imposed costs on the Taliban, and including on its senior leaders. This administration begged. They apologized. They didn't project American strength. And so as they began to make the decision to go down from 2,500, where we had achieved a level space where we could secure the American embassy, prevent exactly what you've seen these past 96 hours. They saw a Biden administration that was weak. They saw it be weak around the world, and they drove a truck through it. And you can see what's happening today around that airport. I know that airport very well. What's happening around that airport today is dangerous. There are still thousands of Americans that are going to really struggle to get there, and I pray that we get this right. The mere fact that they withdrew from 2,500 and have now had to put back 5,000 or 6,000 American soldiers tells you how terribly executed this important strategic mission was for the United States of America.
美国国防部也发表声明说，将在阿富汗增兵。汉克·泰勒少将称，美军在最近24小时内没有针对阿富汗发起任何打击。如果需要，美国有能力实施空袭。连日来，阿富汗喀布尔飞机场非常繁忙，不断有飞机起降，很多人冒着生命危险也要挤上飞机离开阿富汗。美国的运输机更是繁忙，每个运输机里几乎塞满了人。阿富汗大量难民的涌出，这将给美国和国际社会带来大量的安置问题。我们看到，在两天之前，还不断地有塔利班的武装分子来追杀逃跑的民众。美国借此情景，对塔利班的头目说：“如果你们要是阻止阿富汗人的离开，我们将采取更加强大的压倒性的措施来制裁你们。”这两日观察，喀布尔的飞机场现在运作还算正常。据俄罗斯和印度的一些媒体报道说，反塔利班的力量已经集结在潘杰希尔谷